Stored product pest problems are a real nightmare for food processing facilities, as well as grocery stores, pet food stores, food warehouses, and homeowners. As with other pests, identification of stored product pests is a very important part of their treatment because of the differing lifestyles and habits of those pests. In a food processing warehouse, identification combined with monitoring is key. As we stated in the first segment, the quick developmental cycles and life cycles of these pests can create ongoing challenges for pest management specialists. Indian meal moths can be a really difficult problem because they may not necessarily stay in the product the way most beetles do. And there are disturbing health concerns that go along with a stored product pest infestation. A warehouse beetle has spear-shaped hairs on its body and on the skins that it casts, which, if ingested, can cause problems with the very old and the very young. But these pests are just the beginning. So, for this segment, we put together some scenes of some stored product pests you may encounter with some interesting new digital close-up photography that we hope will allow you to really get to know these pests. It didn't take a lot of ingenuity to name the red flower beetle. This is a red beetle that's usually found infesting flour. In the United States, you'll usually find it in the south in the warmer climates. It can be found worldwide, and it usually is found infesting products in the home or in grocery stores. It looks a lot like the confused flower beetle. Maybe that's what made the other flower beetle so confused. Adult red flower beetles are reddish-brown, having antennae with a three-segmented club. The sides of their thorax are rounded, and these two features are just about all that differs them from the confused flower beetle. Confused flower beetles have a four-segmented club, and the sides of their thorax are straight. One of the best resources for telling these two apart is the NPCA field guide. While entomologists may find it interesting, once you get to an issue of control, telling the two apart is not that important because the lifestyle and food preferences of the two pests are virtually identical, making the control measures you need to take identical as well. Although they're usually attracted to flour, especially flour with a high moisture content, they've also been seen infesting grain, beans, peas, nuts, milk chocolate, and even insect specimens in museums. They can cause a foul odor in the flour they infest. Females can live up to 3 years and can lay up to 500 sticky eggs. It's estimated that females will lay 2 to 3 eggs per day. It takes anywhere from 5 to 12 days for the eggs to hatch into larvae. Larvae may have up to 18 instars, but 7 to 8 is the norm. These beetles are about 1/8 of an inch long. Adults have wings and can fly for short distances. They're also attracted to light. Another notorious invader is the cigarette beetle. As the name suggests, these pests like to infest tobacco. You can find this pest all over the world. These beetles have what has been referred to as a strongly humped appearance, which is at least partially the result of their head and thorax being bent downward. They have punctures or pits scattered across their wing covers. Adults can fly and are attracted to light. Experts tell us that they tend to fly in late afternoon or on cloudy days, and they tell us these beetles are more active in subdued light. females will lay up to 42 eggs, which can hatch in 6 to 10 days. These beetles do much better in warmer weather, requiring at least 65 degrees Fahrenheit to reproduce. They infest tobacco and a large number of other products. Rather than trying to read you the list, we thought we'd just let you see for yourself. Here's another pest that has worldwide distribution. Meet the sawtooth grain beetle. We're told it got its name from six teeth located on each side of its prothorax. This pest has a flattened body and is about 1/8 of an inch in length. They're brown, and again, they have these six teeth on either side of the prothorax, which look like a saw. Although they do have wings, they're not listed as being able to fly. Adults are not attracted to light. Although this pest can do considerable damage to grains, we're told by the experts that it cannot attack sound, whole kernels. If packages containing food are not perfectly sealed, the sawtooth grain beetle's flattened body will usually allow it to find an entry point. Females can lay up to 285 eggs, either in clusters or one at a time. These eggs will usually hatch in anywhere from 3 to 17 days, depending on the climate and temperature conditions. The best temperature for these pests to develop in ranges from 86 to 95 degrees Fahrenheit. The life cycle of sawtooth grain beetles usually requires 30 to 50 days. Experts tell us that there can be up to 6 or 7 generations per year, but this is very dependent upon the temperature of their surroundings. Sawtooth grain beetles will attack an extremely large variety of foods, including all of those denoted here. The Indian meal moth is probably the most common stored product pest found in homes and grocery stores, at least in the United States. It was given its common name by Asa Fitch, an early American entomologist. Mr. Fitch found it feeding on cornmeal, or as it was known in that period, Indian meal. This is one of the easier stored product pests to identify because of its wings. Adults will typically have a wing spread of about 5/8 to 3/4 of an inch. As you can see here, the wings are somewhat gray, but they have this interesting copper-toned luster, which makes them very easy to identify. Mature larvae are usually about a half an inch long. Their color can range from a pinkish to greenish or even brownish hue depending on their food source. Although no one likes to discover the adults in a food box, it's not the adults that cause the damage, it's the larvae. The larvae are surface feeders and usually produce a good deal of the webbing that you will find in one of these infestations, which will be embedded in the food materials. The female can lay from 100 to 400 eggs, usually at night. She lays these eggs directly on the food material. The larva will usually attach itself to a crevice of the food material. The larval period can last anywhere from 13 to 288 days. This wide variance is dependent on food availability and temperature. The life cycle of the Indian meal moth is usually 25 to 135 days. These pests are very destructive to dried fruit. The adults can fly and are attracted to light. Here's a list of just some of the foods that they may be found infesting. Sosids are not lice, so the nickname book lice for these insects is misleading. Sosids are very common and abundant insects, but because of their tiny size, they generally go unnoticed. They normally live outdoors in damp places such as under bark and grass, leaves, and on damp wood. However, they may become household pests by flourishing in damp areas of house basements and crawl spaces. Sosids feed on microscopic molds and fungi. They're most numerous in damp, warm, undisturbed situations. Sosids cannot bite or sting and normally don't cause any damage in the foods they infest. However, the dead bodies present in the house dust have been suspected of contributing to asthma attacks in some people. Sosids are found all over the world and throughout the United States, which alone has about 287 different species. Adults are about 6 to 10 millimeters long. Again, they have soft bodies, which some people compare to termite workers, except that these insects are much smaller. Some species have wings, even though the ones we are showing you here do not. Adults have been recorded living over a period of 3 months. The life cycle can be anywhere from 24 to 110 days, depending on the conditions. Sosids can die if there's a drop in the relative humidity below a critical level, which they need to survive. They like areas of high relative humidity because they have a lot of water loss occurring through their exoskeletons. They're referred to as book lice by a lot of people because they can be often found in old books and older homes, especially where there is mold and high relative humidity. There's also a problem in food processing warehouses, groceries, grain elevators, and other food facilities, especially around damp spillage. They've even been found in wooden pallets that have become damp. You may recognize this insect from our open on PCVN. This is a cowpea weevil. They get their common name from the fact that they feed primarily on cowpeas. In the United States, they're mostly found in the southern states. Adults are about 1/16 to 1/8 of an inch long. Both sexes have saw-like antennas. The developmental time can be as short as 23 days when conditions are warm. Adult females lay their eggs on the developing pod in the field or on the bean surface in storage. The female can lay up to 100 eggs, usually with 1 to 3 eggs per seed. The hatchling larva bores directly into the seed. There are 5 larval instars, which require about 20 days to complete. We waited for some time shooting this seed, hoping to capture the moment at which the weevil emerged. And sure enough, the waiting paid off.
Oh man, look at that.
Infestations in packaged products start with small numbers. The longer the product is kept without use, the larger the population grows. Larvae spin silk from their lower lip wherever they go. In large numbers, they can cover the top of a product with silk as they wander around on the surface. As the population grows, larvae may wander outside the package, often for long distances. For example, this can be from a room in lower levels, through holes in the floors, onto upper areas, or from a pantry to the ceiling. They may even dangle from ceilings on silk strands. Their numbers, wandering habits, and large size easily distinguish Indian meal moth larvae from tiny clothes moth larvae that do not wander openly. A pheromone that specifically attracts the flying Indian meal moth is a very effective monitoring tool to use in warehouses and food service or retail sale food stores. In large areas, pheromone trap results can reveal infested areas. There are some general precautions to take for stored product pest infestations. For sawtooth grain beetle infestations, it's a good idea to keep an eye on older products. Older products can generate large populations simply because more generations develop over time. And the more generations you have, the more pests there will be. Finding the infested product and cleaning the area of infestation is very important. Cockroach bait stations with a grain base can sometimes be useful in attracting and killing these beetles. Pesticide sprays would not be a good IPM choice in these infestations. Infested material should be discarded. Then you should clean cracks and crevices in the area. As we have stated before, products with a long shelf life, such as dry animal food, may be susceptible to large pest populations that can build up over time because more attention is given to the rotation of more perishable products. You should include intensive cleaning of warehouses and storage rooms in your recommendations to these clients. Inspect processed flour products and discard those that are infested. Stored products should be rotated, purchased in smaller quantities, and older packages should be discarded if no one plans to use them.